On December 5th of 2024 at 10:44 a.m. local time, an earthquake struck off of California, and this was no typical small magnitude earthquake. Instead, a major magnitude 7.0 earthquake had been generated 33.6 miles west of Cape Mendocino at shallow depths, leading to an alert being sent to everyone in California. Only 9 seconds later, the first seismic wave reached California's landmass, causing the ground to rapidly and strongly shake back and forth for a period of 30 seconds. As this shaking occurred, water splashed and then flowed out of pools, abundant items fell off of shelves and shattered in stores, a door fell off, and more than 10,000 people immediately lost power. Yet, after the shaking finally ended, something even more concerning became apparent. An ocean buoy relatively close to the quake's epicenter suddenly rose and fell more than expected across several minutes, indicating that a tsunami had been generated. As a result, a 511-mile-long stretch of coastline ranging from Dune City, Oregon in the north to Año Nuevo Bay in California to the south was immediately placed under the highest category of a tsunami alert, that being a tsunami warning. In total, more than 5 million people across two states, including in the cities of San Francisco, Eureka, and Crescent City, were told to evacuate to higher ground before the expected waves struck. More than an hour followed in some locations, but thankfully, no widely damaging tsunami reached the shoreline, so the tsunami warning was canceled. A tsunami truly had indeed been generated, but from what I can tell, it only reached a maximum wave height of 12 centimeters or 4.7 inches. What had just occurred was California's largest earthquake in 5 years since the Ridgecrest earthquake struck southeastern California. Thankfully, no deaths or injuries were reported from this event, although the potential that millions of dollars in damage still occurred is considered a high possibility based on the USGS model. So, why did this earthquake occur? Why wasn't there a damaging tsunami? Could an even larger earthquake soon follow, and what might be expected next? Since I am a geologist, I will now answer each of these questions. Yesterday's magnitude 7.0 earthquake struck on what is known as a right lateral strike slip fault. In other words, two faults moved almost completely horizontally to each other with no or only a very, very weak vertical component to it. Because of the lack of a major vertical component, no major tsunami was generated. Major strike slip earthquakes only rarely generate wide-ranging destructive tsunamis, largely due to directly causing large-scale above-sea-level landslides that enter the ocean, or large purely submarine landslides. In this case, it appears as though no major landslides were triggered. While some people are claiming that the December 5th quake struck on the San Andreas Fault, this is not the case. While the northernmost extent of the San Andreas Fault is a mere 12 miles to the east of where the earthquake struck, this major quake struck on what is known as the Mendocino Fault. The Mendocino Fault represents a tectonic plate boundary close to the Mendocino Triple Junction, which is itself a boundary between three tectonic plates. Due to oblique motion of the southern Juan de Fuca plate and the Pacific plate, their interaction creates north-to-south compression along with right lateral translation along the boundary between these two plates. This is why so many earthquakes have struck the region in historical time, with 53 additional quakes larger or equal to a magnitude 6, with one even registering in as a magnitude 7.4 striking the area since 1871. In fact, the last magnitude 6-plus earthquake before yesterday to strike Cape Mendocino was only 2 years ago in 2022. While many people are worried about the risk of aftershocks, the risk of an even larger earthquake soon occurring is very, very low. Based on current modeling, the chance of another magnitude 7.0 or larger earthquake happening in the next week is only 0.5%. This same model suggests higher chances of a magnitude 6 and magnitude 5 aftershock occurring, a near guarantee of a magnitude 4 aftershock, and 33 magnitude 3 quakes of striking by 10:44 a.m. local time on December 12, 2024. The good news is that the frequency of aftershocks and their associated danger decreases with time, following a nice 1 over x ratio, with x representing the number of days after the main shock earthquake, starting at a value of 1, multiplied by the number of aftershocks observed during the first 24 hours. While possibly damaging aftershocks could continue for days, weeks, maybe even months, the risk of additional damage occurring dramatically decreases as the days progress. This, by all means, was not California's concerning future The Big One earthquake. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Helen S., for supporting my work.